What is the best peptide for energy? We're going to answer that question because energy is the vitality of life. Without energy, it's really hard to do anything. And a lot of people make the mistake of leaning on stimulants for energy. Whereas in this video, I'm going to show you exactly what peptide I think is probably the number one peptide for energy production. And I'll show you how to use it. I'll share some studies and then let you decide for yourself how you want to generate energy. So who am I? I'm Regan Archibald. I've written the Peptide Blueprint, which is a comprehensive guide to helping you look, feel, and perform your best at any age. You can go to agelessfuture.com and pick up a downloadable copy of my book there. You can also purchase it on Amazon. You can find my podcast, Ageless Future. Love to have you on the show. And let's dive into the content. So peptides for energy. First of all, energy production is designed to help us outrun the tiger. It's also there so that we can have the energy to sleep and digest our food. Energy is the necessity of life, and without it, I think we've all experienced the moments where we just can't do the things that we want to do. So MOTS-C is a peptide I've talked about a lot in previous videos, but the reason why I chose this one as probably the number one peptide for energy is because it's not just giving you a little boost when you take it. MOTS-C is phenomenal because it's 16 amino acids. And what it does is it goes right into the nucleus of the cell and it turns on these mitochondrial encoded peptides. So it turns on the production of more peptides. And then those peptides, this term is called pleiotropic, those peptides go and they turn on multiple pathways in your body so that your body can generate energy. And I've noticed when I take MOTS-C, I do a little bit in the morning and I just notice all throughout the day, I have nice clean energy. But when I'm done with my cycle, it's not like the energy goes away. It's not like you use coffee for energy, for example, and you get that little spike in the morning and then you're dragging the rest of the day. It's not like that at all. And so MOTS-C is fascinating. Here's what the research shows. In this particular study, what they found is this is called MOTS-C, a promising mitochondrial-derived peptide for therapeutic exploitation. And they talk about the different tissues that co-express this protein, which is the MOTS-C, that works within the nucleus of the cell. And here's what they found. They found that in these tissue structures, MOTS-C improve glucose metabolism in skeletal muscle. And if you think of your ageless axis, that's your muscle, your heart, and your brain. So it worked on the skeletal muscle. They also found that the plasma that contained the protein of MOTS-C, it decreased as we age. So MOTS-C does decline with age, just like growth hormone declines. But they also found that when using MOTS-C, it benefited people who had diseases like diabetes and obesity and metabolic disease. They also found that it was very influential in your body's ability to have proprioception and proper muscle contractility. So if you think of energy generation and you think of MOTS-C, the way that you can fully express MOTS-C is when you exercise. And this is where that sedentary lifestyle, there's no peptide that will outperform exercise that I've seen. MOTS-C is probably the closest one. There's another peptide called SLOOP-332. And that peptide in the initial studies out of the University of Florida, they gave SLOOP, which is a mitochondrial peptide, they gave injections to mice and found that just by one treatment of SLOOP-332, these mice could run 70% farther. Now, that has not necessarily been translated into human studies, but what we'll see is that, you know, the way that it works, the mechanism of action, is by activating the secondary energy system called AMPK. And so whenever you're using MOTS-C, MOTS-C is expressed about 400 to 500% more after exercise. It's also increased by about 300% after a sauna session. You know, sauna session, 160 degrees in a dry sauna for about 20 minutes, you're going to have an enormous increase in your MOTS-C expression. But the way that you want to activate this pathway is by using NAD. And NAD is a sirtuin activator. And what NAD does is it cleans up the cell. So it activates these little proteins that allow your DNA to express health on a greater level. MOTS-C is also found in the skeletal muscle. And in the skeletal muscle, you have these satellite stem cells. And when MOTS-C is expressed, your muscles actually recover faster. So think about the energy generation that you have after you've exercised. It's not necessarily that exercise in and of itself when you're doing it. Yes, I get energy when I exercise, but I feel so good after I exercise. And especially I sleep better. I notice that my cognition's improved. And that's because MOTS-C is one of the major things that are generating. It's not just that initial ATP production, but it's like a secondary bypass. So if you've ever driven in a Tesla and it's got the regenerative braking system, you take your foot off the gas pedal and then the braking kicks in, and the braking is like giving the battery energy from the resistance on the tires. And then your battery can actually increase. I remember taking my Tesla down Parley's Canyon years ago, and I was able to generate more energy in my battery, and it did it every single time. That's what MOTS-C is doing. It's restoring the reserves in your body. What happens when you do stimulants like caffeine or Adderall, Ritalin, some of these like Vyvanse, some of the things for treatments for ADHD, is you're depleting your energy reserves. There's no braking system on it. So all you're getting is pure stimulant, but you're not getting any regeneration. So MOTS-C is one of the most powerful ways you can regenerate your body's energy systems. And if you're using a growth hormone releasing peptide like sarcotropin, CJC1295, tesamorelin, which go check out my videos on tesamorelin. I think you'll enjoy knowing how to take it, when to take it, when to cycle off, how to stack peptides. We'll provide a link in the show notes for you so you can watch those if you're interested. But when you're taking growth hormone peptides, you're activating mTOR, and the opposite of mTOR is AMPK. And so that's that yin and yang balance where you can have your cake and eat it too. And that's why I love peptides so much, is because you can activate energy pathways with MOTS-C through that secondary energy system, AMPK, and then you can decrease your risk of having, you know, issues with growth hormone by working on the mTOR, so you can have muscle building and you can diminish any chances of cancer or, you know, chronic disease. So this is beautiful balance. The other thing is, if you add in the NAD with the MOTS-C, what you'll notice is it provides fuel for your body. So is MOTS-C something you should be taking? Well, let's do a quick quiz, and you can plug in the comments below to see if this peptide may be of interest to you. Do you have insulin resistance? So look at your blood labs, and one of the major markers that indicate, this person may need some MOTS-C, is look at your lactose dehydrogenase markers. And if your levels are not between about 150 and 200, there's a good chance, if it's too low, that you're not getting the energy supply that you want, or if it's too high, your body can't handle all of the inputs. And so your cells have like a sluggish ability to make energy. Second marker you want to look at is your anion gap. And what the anion gap is it shows the distance between your electrolytes. If the anion gap is high, then there's a good chance that you're not getting the energy spark that you want, because your electrolytes are so spaced out, and usually it's from too high levels of stress. And so what you can do with that anion gap is you can work on the digestive system, lots of breathing, work on the vagal tone, and then you can also start adding in cold exposure. So any kind of cold plunging, it activates that epinephrine pathway and it resets that HPA axis. So MOTS-C has been a phenomenal peptide. The studies are just very impressive. It's probably the closest thing that I've seen to exercise in a bottle. Now we have the GLP-1, so you can lose weight, you can do it without enormous amounts of sacrifice and willpower. And if you stack MOTS-C with your already active lifestyle, you'll just notice you'll be able to enjoy those activities that you love more and more, and you'll continually generate energy until your 90s, 100s, maybe 150, who knows? You could be like Dan Sullivan, one of my mentors of Strategic Coach, whose goal is to live to be 156. And MOTS-C will be one of those peptides that will help him get to where he wants to go. Speaking of MOTS-C, if you really enjoyed this and you say, man, I just want a little more of the data on it, then you'll want to go to my next video on the powerhouse peptide by clicking the link below, and I'll see you there.